Everybody loves a good magic trick. And if we're being honest, part of the fun is knowing we're being fooled. After all, plenty of classic illusions would go from entertaining to horrifying pretty quickly if you actually believed they were real. Take mind reading, obviously a harmless piece of stagecraft. But what would it mean if the gap between magic and reality were to get just a little smaller? And mind reading became more than just a fun party piece, and instead a fact of everyday life, powered by one of the wonders of medical science, brain scanning. Scanning people's brains may sound futuristic, but its history actually goes back to 1924, when Hans Berger first used an electroencephalogram, or EEG, to measure the electrical signals of a human brain and diagnose epilepsy. EEGs are still in use today, but in the intervening 100 years, the medical world has also gained a wide range of other scans, with probably the best known and most powerful being functional magnetic resonance imaging. An fMRI scanner works by using a powerful magnet to pull the protons in water molecules inside a patient's body into alignment, then using radio frequency pulses to knock them back out of alignment. As the protons are pushed and pulled, they give out tiny radio signals, which are picked up by the scanner. Now, what's important is that the strength of these signals varies according to the blood's oxygen content. The harder a region of the brain is working, the more oxygen gets delivered there. So by detecting which parts have the strongest signals, and so the most oxygenated blood, the scanner tracks the regions of the brain working hardest, while the patient is thinking, speaking, listening, or doing whatever else. From that information, neuroscientists have been able to figure out which areas are associated with which functions, building up a map of the brain in action. fMRI is one of the most powerful tools we have for understanding the brain's complex inner workings. But recently, scientists have been able to go even further by combining fMRI with artificial intelligence. And the results are pretty jaw-dropping. In one study, researchers showed video clips to patients undergoing fMRI, then fed the scan results into the same kind of AI model behind ChatGPT, which gradually learned to interpret participants' unspoken responses, even picking up on specific words and phrases they were thinking, in effect, reading their minds. In another, scan results were fed into the generative AI model Stable Diffusion, which, with practice, was able to more or less reconstruct the content of videos the participants had been shown. And elsewhere, similar results have even been achieved with less sophisticated technology. In a study at UC Berkeley, participants played video games while wearing EEGs, during which time the researchers managed to identify the players' addresses and bank details completely undetected. Now, from a purely technical and scientific angle, this is all very impressive. But from a civil rights, personal privacy, Black Mirror perspective, it's kind of terrifying. The idea that brain scanning could be used to reveal our thoughts and secrets is chilling. But if the last decade of life online has taught us anything, it's that the biggest danger doesn't come from neuroburglars extracting our personal data. Instead, time and again, we've shown that when a gadget or website, shiny and exciting enough, comes along, many of us are likely to hand our data over entirely willingly. What if Silicon Valley's latest must-have device included built-in brain scanning technology, giving a giant corporation direct access to your mind? Okay, this probably sounds a bit alarmist and over the top. After all, fMRI scanners are massive, noisy, and wildly expensive. They're hardly going to be built into the next generation of smartphones. But what about a similar, more portable technology, which could fit into a headband, or even something as discreet as, say, a pair of earphones? Like these AirPods with built-in EEG, which were patented by Apple in July 2023. With one of the biggest companies in the world embracing this technology, it's not beyond the realm of possibility that wearable brain scanners could become widespread in the near future, making awareness of its potential uses and abuses a far more urgent issue. Now, it's important to note that there are huge potential benefits to be gained from this kind of technology too. Wearable EEGs could warn people with epilepsy before a seizure starts, or help treat migraines and sleep disorders. Many workers in high-risk industries, such as mining, already wear EEGs to monitor their fatigue levels, helping to prevent accidents. But it isn't hard to imagine the less savory possibilities, where brain scan data might become just one more piece of personal information, influencing who gets admitted to which school, who gets hired or fired, who gets imprisoned or released. In the age of surveillance capitalism, it's already important to ask ourselves what private info we're handing over and who might get hold of it. But that question is only going to become more relevant and pressing as brain scanning technology continues to evolve and mind reading steps off the stage and into the street.